You tuned into the Sandbox Network with Elegant Miss Diamond, Grandma Pudding, and Hussein Fatal. Tune in Saturday to get that interview. Like I said, Hussein Fatal, Miss Elegant Diamond, and Grandma Pudding. Sandbox Radio Network. Tune in live. Now let me get back to fucking doing what I was doing. You tuned into the Sandbox Network with Elegant Miss Diamond, Grandma Pudding, and Hussein Fatal. Tune in Saturday to get that interview. Like I said, Hussein Fatal, Miss Elegant Diamond, and Grandma Pudding. Sandbox Radio Network. Tune in live. Now let me get back to fucking doing what I was doing.
The station with the
best music.
I love the music.
This is Britney Spears.
What up, this is Jay-Z.
This is Jennifer Lopez.
In your face, all over the place.
We're online. You're listening to the hottest internet station.
You've entered the sandbox.
Where we all come together, taking the latest dirt, slanging it from social media headlines, politics, celebrity gossip, sports gossip, and society news, and building our own sandcastle by chatting live in the sandbox with the diva of the South herself, Elegant, and ATL hot track maker,
Miss Diamond Tracks.
Let's not forget the grandma of radio herself, Grandma Puddin'.
And you know, I'm gonna get her to your room and uncut.
You've entered the sandbox.
Be loyal, my nigga. From the cradle to the grave.
Hazelwood Beat.
Yeah. Be loyal, my nigga. That's a lifestyle. 'Cause I'ma be loyal to you.
Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. Out the sunroof, wrong way, one way. They switch up on me, they gon' learn one day. No, he ain't loyal, and he ain't about gunplay. Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. Out the sunroof, wrong way, one way. They switch up on me, they gon' learn one day. He ain't loyal, and he ain't about gunplay. Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. Lord on the side now, but he get caught one day. Two wrongs don't make no right, but three left to. It's all about a murder for hire, so free my nephew. Some niggas talking disrespect to those walking with it. Me, I got it cocked in my pocket, ain't got to park and get it. Killers on the side of me, respect my notoriety. So nigga bound down and existing, and it's the pride of me. $1 million dreaming, $1 billion fiending. Fuck winning, dumbass shades, I got the beaming. 16 leaning, hey, body screaming. Hospital bed, puppies weaning. Nurse gotta feed you through food so you can get a meal. See, that's what you do to your dude. Soon as you get a deal, homies ain't loyal for shit. They don't care if you slip, so I'm always with my strap and a chip. Get out of here. Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. Out the sunroof, wrong way, one way. They switched up on me, they gon' learn one day. No, he ain't loyal, and he ain't about gunplay. Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. Out the sunroof, wrong way, one way. They switched up on me, they gon' learn one day. He ain't loyal, and he ain't about gunplay.
Riding all week on Saturday especially. Rubber grip, 8-shot pound, that's a specialty. Out here teaching them, and haters keep testing me. If you ain't ever did time, then don't stand next to me. Sick of seeing young niggas frontin' like they OG. In front, they mama house. Real niggas is OT. Queens playing offense, but you ain't got no D. Can't make bail, so you snitching on your code D. Ran through the streets with him, hated on the government, but now I can't eat with him. Damn, where my brother went. Fast life slowed down, hey, body switched up. Real niggas push back, soft niggas end up. Funny acting niggas are hoax. I've been around long enough to know you money flashing. Niggas is broke, and while you on camera flashing your coat, I'm trying to figure if the new Mini Mac 11 come with a scope. 'Cause I be
riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. Out the sunroof, wrong way, one way. They switched up on me, they gon' learn one day. He ain't loyal, and he ain't about gunplay. Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. Out the sunroof, wrong way, one way. They switched up on me, they gon' learn one day. He ain't loyal, and he ain't about gunplay.
I don't got
gotta do much talking. I let the nine speak. Your swag on crack. Your hustle on client sleep. Jokers watching IG channel to get they heart up. But all they get is AC bullets soon as it start up. 4-4 with outlaw. Dying is my destiny. Appetite for destruction and murder be the recipe. Be enough for 30 for they can even get next to me. But drugs give them confidence. Molly, ecstasy. Cats walking zombies. Dead. Won't lay down. Calling out for mommy. Head hit with a kid round. Caught by the cleanup. Just to put in work scene. Shots make them dance around a block like a twerk scene. Haters been hating. I got shooters on the payroll. They don't like when I come around cause I'm an a-hole. Freeze the whole spot. Nobody moves so I say so. This ain't Play-Doh, nigga. You got Play-Doh. Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. House of sunroof. Wrong way, one way. They switched up on me. They gon' learn one day. No, he ain't loyal. And he ain't about gunplay. Riding all week on a Monday to Sunday. House of sunroof. Wrong way, one way. They switched up on me. They gon' learn one day. He ain't loyal. And he ain't about gunplay.
Yes, and that was Fatal Hussein. I mean, I'm so excited, Miss Diamond Tracks and Grandma Puddin'. If you live joining in the sandbox, you are tuning in to Celebrity Saturdays, where we will have one of Tupac's closest and dearest friends in the sandbox. And tell them who that would be, Miss Diamond Tracks.
Hussein Fatal.
Yes, Hussein Fatal will be in the sandbox in just a few minutes. And Grandma Puddin', where are you?
I'm right here.
Okay, and I can't wait to have everyone up in the sandbox with Hussein Fatal. I'm sure they have so many questions and to ask him in regards of Tupac. I'm so excited. Someone that was so dear to him that he spoke about very highly. I'm just very, very excited.
Yes.
And, yes. I can't wait. I can't wait. I know he has a lot to discuss. What do you say?
Yes. Well, I'm definitely interested in what he has to say. I have some questions that I really want to find out from him, and I can't wait to talk to him.
Yeah, I can't wait to talk to him myself, because I know that if no one out here right now that could ever take the place of Tupac Shakur, that man was so legendary. He was just at the peak of his career before they ended his life. And I'm very, very honored to be able to speak to someone of that magnitude in regards of Tupac Shakur and the phenomenal group, the Outlaws. So I'm looking forward to that.
Yes.
So since we have just a few minutes before they are coming into the sandbox, maybe even a minute, let's go to one of the most well-known records from Tupac featuring the Outlaws. That will be also Hussein Fatal is featured on this record. Actually, he raps right after Pac. You know that, Miss Diamond Tracks, Grandma Puddin'? Let's go into... Yeah, let's go into Hit 'Em Up. Tupac Shakur featuring the Outlaws.
Yo, I ain't got no friends. Yeah, I'ma do this track. Westside, MOB, Bad Boy Killer. Hey, Fat Boy. First off, touch your chick in the click you claim. Westside, when we rock, I'm equipped with game. You claim to be a player, but I bust your wife. We bust on Bad Boys, brothers touch for life. Plus, Buffy trying to see me beat hearts I rip. Biggie Smalls and Junior Mafia, some mark ass tricks. We keep on coming while we gunning for your juice. Steady rushing while we busting at your fools. You know the rules, Lil Caesar, go ask your homie, I'll leave you. Cut your trick ass up, leave you in pieces. Now be deceased, Lil Kim, don't come.
Bad boy murdered on wax and kill. Mess with me and get your cats killed. You know, grab your Glocks when you see Tupac. Call the cops when you see Tupac. Who shot me? But your punk sitting finished. Now you're about to feel the wrath of a menace. Sucker, I hit him up. Yeah, straight out on a bad boy camp. You know how we do it. Yeah. All my real homeboys in New York, keep thugging. All the rest of you busters, die slow.
Get out the way.
Welcome our special guest, Hussein Fatal.
Hussein, welcome to the Sandbox. This is your host, Elegant.
The Sandbox.
Okay, we could barely hear you, Hussein.
I said, what's happening? What's good? Thanks for having me. What's going on?
What's going on? It's such an honor to have you in the Sandbox right now. How you doing today?
I'm doing good. I can't complain right now. I'll be selfish if I try to complain at this point.
Yeah.
Right, right. Right, yeah. Right.
So how y'all doing? What we got going on? What's the topic? Let's get the show on.
Oh, boy, let me tell you the topic right now.
Okay.
Well, the topic that we have today, we always build our topic around each one of our celebrity guests. And
right.
Our topic is, what's more fatal, love or hate? You want to go into that real quick?
Oh, yeah, that could be simple and easy. The love is definitely more fatal. The love is way more fatal than the hate. Should I go into depth?
Yes, please.
Well, shit, with the love, you know, Abe, can I curse?
Go ahead, do your thing. It's Celebrity
Saturday.
Well,
in my opinion, you know, when motherfuckers act like it's love, you know, you more bound to fall into some bullshit rather than the motherfucker. If you know somebody hates you, then you know. You, at least you know that about them. But with the love, it's a lot of fake shit going on. So you bound to walk into a brick wall with somebody that's faking like they love you every single time. No?
Yes.
No?
Right. You're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Okay.
You think that's right, or is you just saying that?
No. Well, I mean, I think it's absolutely right. I mean, from that perspective, yes.
Oh, all right.
Yes, it is. That's
my take on it.
You're right when you say a whole lot of folk out here faking and stuff, trying to act like they love you and they're using you, they're using you and taking up your time. And I agree with what you say about love being more fatal.
Exactly.
I done came across a few jokers in my lifetime. And it was all in the name of love.
Man, but please, you've been walked into a building with a motherfucker you think got love for you. You come out the building and the nigga been shot your ass 10 times. And you the dummy because you think this nigga love you, but it's really hate. The love be so fake,
right.
But the hate be so real.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it does. Well, fatal. I want to go into the interview really quick because we have so many callers that, you know, love you to pieces and been waiting for you, that been following you since day one. And I myself would like to go into the interview. And then what we do is we let our fans and callers and followers and listeners, everybody just, you know, get up and close and personal. But right now, Fatal, I want to ask you, how did you become a member of the Outlaws?
Well, Gaddafi, we all know, was related to Tupac. And where I'm from, you know, in my hood, I took care of Gaddafi for a long time before I even knew he was with Tupac and all that silly shit. But, you know, he introduced me. One day he said the nigga Pac wanted to meet me and shit. Well, his mother told me that, and they took my ass up to the jail where Pac was at. And the nigga Pac was like, yeah, when I get out of here, I'm putting a group together, blah, 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 blah. And when he got out, he did just that. And here we are.
Wow. Do you remember what it was like meeting the legendary Tupac Shakur for the first time? Can you go down memory lane? Like, what was it like? Because I would have been nervous as hell.
I mean, I wasn't nervous at all because we went to a jail to see him. And back then, a jail was my comfort zone. So when I went and seen him, it was like he was in his jail shit. And, you know, we were sitting across from him. And it was just like, damn, this nigga's in jail and shit. You know, he was just basically making promises. So it was like, you know, some regular shit. Plus, his brother was so cool to me, it already felt like I knew the guy.
Oh, okay. Ms. Diamond Tracks, you had a question?
Yes. Fatal, before getting, you know, into the Outlaws, had you had a career in rap or no?
Definitely not. I was a street guy, and I wasn't even thinking about rapping and shit. It was like, you know, even when I got with Pac, when we went over there, it was like we already had some shit going on in Jersey, me and Gaddafi. Like, we already had the hood, so rapping, we wasn't thinking about that shit. Every time we went to Cali, we was trying to get the fuck back, basically, because we was doing shit, but that shit just took off and became something else. So to answer your question, definitely not.
Okay. Grandma Pudding? Yes, Peter. Who or what inspired you to become a rapper or to go ahead and move forward with the Outlaws?
Well, shit. Artists like KRS-One and shit, you know, Kool G Rap, Rakim, I wasn't really, you know, into no Jersey rap niggas and shit like that. I had a chance. I knew a bunch of Jersey rappers, but none of them motherfuckers even thought about, you know, putting, basically didn't even know my name. They might have knew me from some street shit. I was beefing with a bunch of Jersey rappers. So by me getting with Tupac, that shit was like even a slap in their face, most of them. So, you know, what inspired me was, you know, KRS-One and all the old heads I used to listen to.
Okay. Well, we do have some callers who have some questions for you.
I would like to ask another question, Fatal, as well. Fatal, let me ask you, with Amin and Young Noble, Gaddafi, what was it like being on tour with them? Who was like the craziest personality on tour?
Shit, probably Tupac. Oh, out of the Outlaws?
Shit, yeah, out of the Outlaws.
Probably Napoleon. Napoleon was the wildest, as far as, you know, Napoleon was a hothead before he made his change over and shit. But we really ain't go on tour back then. Back then, we probably did about 5 shows, I can remember. It wasn't no tour shit. We was just all in Cali fucking around. We didn't even get a chance. That shit was so short-lived, we didn't even get a chance to do shit.
Okay. I see you keep yourself in shape. How important is fitness to you?
Well, after Gaddafi died, I really wasn't thinking straight. I was a little, you know, I was doing all kinds of motherfucking drugs, you know, as far as, you know, pills and shit, downers and all that shit. I really was trying to die and shit. And then, you know, I had kids and all that. As I grew older, I woke up and I wasn't fucking dead. And I looked in the mirror and I'm like, man, I'm too grown to be looking like a fucking little-ass kid. So I just felt like I got to do something different with myself. And I just started, you know, getting in shape. I didn't start like, yeah, I'm going to get in shape. I just started doing push-ups and shit. And once I seen results, it was like, wow, I moved out of Jersey. And once I started working out, I started thinking different. Like, I started making better decisions about, you know, just life, period. And so, you know, I just kept on with this shit. Now, it's like some shit that I have to do. Plus, I want to live long.
Right.
I want to see my kids. I don't want to be all out here with high cholesterol and all that shit.
And that's a great thing. I want to ask you this one question before we go into our callers. I want to know, Fatal, what was you doing and where were you when you received the news that Tupac had been murdered?
I was in Newark, New Jersey. I know exactly where I was. I was in Newark, New Jersey on 16th Avenue about to make a right on Fairmont to go get some fucking weed. And I was in the car with a couple of goons, and they said Pac got shot. You know, I didn't believe it. And I fucked around, and it was true.
So I'm sure, like, when you heard that Pac gotten shot, I'm sure you felt like, you know what, he's going to get through this because he's basically been through so much.
I didn't
and he survived
like
so many things.
I didn't feel like that, to tell you the truth. That's what they fucking said. That's what they said on the news. Like, the nigga, I mean, they said it, not me. If you, I'm sure, I probably can remember better than anybody. But they said he was okay, stable condition. Motherfucking, you go to sleep and this nigga is fucking gone, disappeared, and all this other shit.
Okay, well, we have, yeah, that's what I'm saying. I thought he was going to pull through. I remember the night that he was murdered. I mean, it was crazy. It was like his music was playing everywhere. People was crying, playing his music, standing on top of cars. It was so turned up. I remember it was almost like a parade slash death of a concert. It was crazy. Like, this man was so well loved and still is to this day. You know, I want all my callers and listeners, if you just tuning into the Sandbox right now, you're in the Sandbox with the Outlaws member, Hussein Fatal, and also you're with Miss Diamond Tracks, Grandma Puddin', and Elegant, and our topic for today was what's more fatal, love or hate? And back to Tupac's, that moment, I mean, people, you would have thought that he was related to everyone.
Yeah.
When you saw the tears, when you saw the emotion and everything, you would have thought he was related to everyone the way that it was. And I felt that, and I would say that I was so touched. I was emotional myself. I love Tupac, and rest in peace, Tupac. And I know that, you know, this whole music thing, he changed the game. And right now, I want to go into a caller right now that's been waiting for you so patiently, one of the first callers. 3537, you're live in the Sandbox with Hussein Fatal. You have a question or a comment?
Go ahead. You already know, my man. What's good with it?
We out in Philly. We fucking with you. Know I follow you on the Grand Heavy. You my man, man. We be thanking the Outlaw shit heavy, man. But I wanted to ask you, Yola Slime on Instagram, but I wanted to ask you, do you think Yaki Gaddafi's death was overlooked because Pac died?
Yeah, it was. I mean, Pac, motherfucker, we don't know where the fuck Tupac at. Ain't nobody seen no fucking body of that nigga. And Gaddafi, Pac was cool, but don't get it fucked up. This is how everybody get it fucked up. Pac was cool, my man, but Gaddafi, man, that was motherfucking bro, my nigga. And that shit definitely, it didn't get overlooked. It was just like, you know, it was like, damn, one of the Outlaws died. You know, which is, you know, I guess it was what it was, but I definitely feel like it did. You know what I mean? And to this day, motherfuckers still ain't see this nigga Pac dead yet. So niggas ain't even paying attention to what really, how that shit really affected. I don't know how it affected other niggas in the group, but me? That shit crushed me, bro.
It's fucked. That shit crushed. That shit made you stop fucking with rap after that. That shit was done.
Yeah, definitely. Like, I was done with all rap, anything, hip-hop. That shit was dumb to me. Like, I ain't even want to do that shit because I felt like I lost my brother to some shit that we ain't even motherfucking sign up for. We was just out there. When we in Gaddafi joint that shit, it was like, my nigga, you know, we was just holding Pac down. That's what it was. Fuck the rats. We was out there, you know, bulletproof vest. Niggas used to be talking about it. Like, I thought I was going to die first, nigga, because I was the cannon. I'm like, you know, I'm ready. Like, when is it going down? When that shit happened in Vegas, I was so mad that I missed it. Like, I had a chance to die for this nigga. And now I got to be out here doing interviews and shit on the phone and shit. Like, that shit ain't cool to me, my man.
Well, but look, man, I'm only 18. I'm Tupac, though. You know what I mean?
That's what's up. Yup.
You know what I mean? I salute, though. Stay 050. Stay away from 550. You already know. East side up.
All the time, bro. All
right. Holla at you.
Yup. What up? Hello? Miss Grandma. What the fuck is Abel?
Grandma.
Oh, here y'all go.
Yes.
I'm like, where y'all at? That shit sounding like.
No, we right here. We right here. Nah, Grandma Putin is here. Miss Diamond Tracks is here. I'm here. Thank you, caller. Right now we have caller 8773. You have a question or a comment for Hussein Fatal. Caller 8773, do you have a question or a comment for Fatal? I guess they're afraid to say anything.
Damn.
I'm going to ask one more time. 8773, area code 706. Do you have a question or a comment for Hussein Fatal? Okay. All right, let me go to the next caller. Caller, let me see, 3323, you're live in the sandbox. You have a question or a comment for Hussein Fatal.
How y'all doing? This King right here. I just want to shout out the host, Elegant Diamond Trash, Grandma Puddin', and of course today's, today's artist on the show, Fatal Man. I just had one question for you, bro. As far as hip hop and where it stands at today, I mean, with the Outlaws and Tupac, you guys created the brand as far as thug rapping, you know what I'm saying, as far as putting real shit out there, as far as, what really goes down. What do you think about today as far as these new rappers? Like, one in particular I had on my mind, like Young Thug, these rappers out here claiming to do shit, but they on a whole nother level. What you think about that, man?
I mean, I really can't have an opinion, because that's like, shit changes, man. Shit definitely can't stay the same forever, and how it changes is not up to us. That shit just changes, And, shout out to the homie Young Thug and all them other niggas doing that shit, doing their thing. It's like, it's like a double-edged sword. Like, that shit, for number one, like, hip-hop made a dramatical change, man. It's bigger than just the artist, my nigga. It's like after that fake East Coast-West Coast war, you got to believe that the powers that be somehow has something to do with, like, we going to change this shit whether people like it or not. We're not going to play these conscious niggas. We're not going to play Common Sense. We're not going to play Talib Kweli. We're going to play people that's out there telling motherfuckers to spend up all their money, telling motherfuckers to wear this and wear that. We're going to brainwash that motherfucking community, and then, we're going to have motherfuckers, we're going to put rappers in order. Like, I don't want to say take away from no other artists out there, race or nothing like that, because hip-hop is hip-hop. But us as a people got to learn to take care of our shit, or motherfuckers is going to swoop in while we thinking about some other unimportant shit. They're going to swoop in from the back end and just take your shit. I mean, we get our shit took in every fucking, like, it makes no sense to me. But to answer your question, I don't got no opinion about that shit. Shit changed, man. You just got to change with it.
All right, bro. I respect that, man. I appreciate you for coming on the show, showing everybody love. It's Diamond Tracks, Elegant, Grandma Puddin'. I appreciate y'all for letting me get on here and have a comment. This King, I'm out.
All right, peace.
Okay.
Thank you.
And
you too.
Thank you so much. All right. And we have another caller. Caller 9360, do you have a question or a comment? You're live in the sandbox. Caller 9360.
Why do you leave
hello,
that
hello, caller 9360. You're live in the sandbox. Area code 412. You're live in the sandbox. Oh, well, I guess they're just wanting to listen in. Oh, boy. We have a lot of callers. Oh, my goodness. Caller 9219, you're live in the sandbox.
Yes.
Caller 9219, you're live in the sandbox. Do you have a question or a comment?
I have a question. Yes, I do. I have a question.
Okay.
My name is Monte Crispa. I reside here in Miami, Florida, and I would like to know, where did you come up with your stage name? Because it's unique, it's different, and I'd like to know that.
Well, before I even came, my name was already Fatal when I was in the hood, in my own hood. My name was already Fatal. But then when we got with Pop, this nigga, this crazy guy, He was like, we should all get names of the people that governments hate. And you know Hussein came about because I had my hood under siege already, like the real Hussein. That shit could have been Iraq, and I was the real Hussein. So that shit was like, fuck it, Hussein. That's all.
Okay. Are you working on any new projects at the moment, knowing that 2015 is around the corner?
Well, we got some shit in the making. You know, I pretty much can't talk about, but what I can talk about is this book that's already done that I'm going to wind up trying to put out after this Tupac biopic come out, whenever that is. So that's my next thing. I got the website, fatalbelly.com. You can log on to that. You know, give you a lot of workout tips and show you what we're currently working on. You know, we got the outlawuniversity.net clothing. We got the Be Loyal clothing coming soon. You know, we working.
Wow, well, I salute you on your mission. Real talk. You're like one of the realest ones out here right now.
Appreciate you.
Okay. Thank you for tuning in to Sandbox Caller. Also, we have caller 1533. You're live in the Sandbox. Caller 1533, you're live in the Sandbox.
What's
Do you
up,
have a
Fader?
Question or a comment?
What's good?
What's up, Fader? I'm good, man.
Your phone breaking up, caller.
I wanted to ask, what was the funniest memory you got of Pac?
The funniest? It's a bunch of them, but it's definitely this one time, man, when we was out and he decided he wanted to go. Because you got to remember, back then, I was kind of older, man. I was like, you know, I was like 21, 22, and the nigga Pac, you know, I had ID. So it's like he wanted to jump out. He wanted to go somewhere one day without security and shit. And we motherfucking went to some strip club. But anyway, we got all drunk and shit. Man, this dude started driving fast as hell in his act and shit. And you know, in L.A., they got them motherfucking, on the 405, they got them bumps in the road or something.
Like, yeah. The Jag was, like, jumping over the bumps, and he just looking at me laughing like the shit was funny. And I'm holding on tight as hell like, damn, we about to die on the fucking highway.
That was one time, but hold on, here's another one. We was on Melrose Place in Cali, and we was in some shop, and I seen her looking like Janet Jackson and shit, so I let her walk by, right? I ain't say nothing because I ain't want to be all starstruck and shit. I ain't want to tell him. He going to be like, man, he's starstruck. So like 3 minutes passed. I'm like, yo, I think I just saw Janet Jackson. That nigga turned around like, where'd she go? He like, why the fuck you ain't tell me where she was at? He was stupid motherfucker. Yo, he went and chased this lady down, and it was a fucking lookalike. Yo, that shit was funny as hell.
Oh, man.
Yo, that shit was funny as hell. We made a joke out of it at the end, but yo, that shit was funny as hell. But yeah, that's about it.
I appreciate you sharing the stories, man.
It's all good, man.
Yes. I want to ask you another question, Fatal. What was it like when you saw yourself doing the first video, like you actually see it on television? What was that moment like?
It was over. Well, when I was in Cali, it was like, you know, when I was in Cali and I saw it, it really wasn't nothing new. But when I went home, you know, back then we had, like, the box. You could order the motherfucking video on the box. You ain't had to wait for your shit to
come
on.
That's a throwback right there.
Word. We used to have full control of the shit. So I'm sitting there. I ain't even tell. See, you got to remember, I was a wild child. You know, my mother, you know, she was cool. She did the best she could. But I could spend a night out. I could just be somewhere, and it wasn't nothing. So I didn't even tell these mothers I was going to Cali and shit. My family and life, I just left.
I got on a plane and went to Cali and shit. I come back home and all that, and the box is on. I go to my grandparents' house and shit. We sitting there.
Then I call, my brother come downstairs, and he ordered the video on the fucking box, and that shit came on, and all my family was just looking at me like I was a fucking stranger, like they couldn't believe. You know, me coming from Cali, I already knew, like, you know, it wasn't nothing for me. But the family was like, oh, God, nigga, you made it. Like, they couldn't believe this shit. And it was like, yo, they just looked at me different as hell ever since then. Because, you know, I used to, before that, I used to run around the house writing rhymes and all this silly shit, coming from jail with a rap book, and they looking at me crazy like, nigga, you better get a fucking job or a GED or something. And then come to find out, next thing I know, I'm on the fucking box. So it was pretty weird for them and shit. For the, to see the shit back home, it was definitely awesome to me.
And what about radio? what happened with radio? With the radio, I meant to say radio. Then you know that particular seeing yourself on television. I know I always tell a lot of crazy stories about radio. Where were you when you heard it on radio for the first time?
When I heard the music on radio?
Yes, when you heard the music on radio for the first time.
Well, we heard, the first thing I heard on the radio was fucking Hit 'Em Up. We was actually in Cali. I heard Hit 'Em Up the day after we did the shit. The shit happened so fast. It was like, you know,
what?
We laying in the bed. Yeah, we laying in the bed at the Oakwoods, and the shit just came on the radio. Once it came on the radio, you know, Kadhaf and all them woke me up like, yo, the shit on the radio. So we listening to it. Then, like, maybe like an hour after that, all the homies from Jersey started calling, like, yo, every car up here is playing that shit, blah, and all that. But in Jersey, you wouldn't hear, they don't play that shit. They don't play that shit. They play that shit all over the world. But Jersey and New York, they don't play that shit. They probably play Dead Fucking Mama around Mother's Day. That's it.
What?
That's it. They don't play
nothing
too proud. They might act like they want to play that shit maybe on an anniversary or something, but they really don't. They only play that shit because the call comes from upstairs. They don't play that shit.
It sounds like New Jersey got some haters.
Say that again?
I say it sounds like New Jersey got some haters.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know,
like
it's love. It's love out there, but you got to take it. But you got to remember, it ain't Jersey. It ain't Jersey. It's like, you know, New York controls the whole tri-state area as far as radio. You know what I'm saying? We only got one radio station for New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut. Nobody wants to put Jersey on. Pop, that's why Pop, he shocked the world when motherfuckers, he brought some niggas from Jersey over because, you know, motherfuckers know about Jersey, but Pop is like, I'm putting these niggas on. Plus, he knew Tretch and all them crazy motherfuckers.
Yes,
so he put us on.
I have another caller, 7092. Caller 7092, do you have a question or a comment? You're live in the sandbox. Caller 7092. Okay, I guess they're just listening. I have a lot of listeners. I want to ask another question, Fatal. Another thing. What was your fondest memory in the studio with Tupac? The studio. Do you have any studio memories, like, you know, being in the studio with him and, you know, what was
I ain't got a lot. I mean, we used to work hard in the studio. I used to be the blunt roller until a couple of other outlaw members came up, and I started handing them the weed. It was like a chain of command. But we used to beat niggas the fuck up. Niggas used to come to the session and be like, yo, if the outlaws is in there, we don't want to work. Pac used to be like, yo, come in there with his crazy-ass laugh. Y'all can't come in today. Blah, don't want y'all in there. The niggas scared. You know, I ain't going to put nobody out there. It was a couple of niggas that was like, yo, because niggas used to beat niggas up. That was back in the day. Niggas, I'm quite sure we ain't on it like that now, but, you know, that's what it was in the 90s. But beating niggas up,
that was my
fondest memory.
Okay, we have our GM in the sandbox right now. Caller, Fly Ass Day, you're live in the sandbox.
Yo, what's up, Fatal? What's happening, bro?
What's going on, man? One day at a time, brother.
I hear it. I appreciate you coming in the sandbox today, all the listeners, and all the supporters that's tuning in today. Shout out to Elegant, Diamond Tracks, Miss Diamond Tracks, Grandma Pretty, my brother King Asata. A question of mine, man, is, you know,
with the Outlaws right now, what y'all are doing, you know what I'm saying, it seems like, you know, have anybody like, you know, Snoop, anybody like that has reached back out to y'all, you know what I mean? Because I know all the
Hell
work
no.
that Pac did, you know what I'm saying, you know, working with him and shit like that, you know, I want to know if anybody like that has, you know, reached out that was around Pac, you know, Dre, any of them type of people like that.
Hell no. Hey, yo, like me, I don't, niggas ain't looking for handouts. When Death wrote, when Pac died, I went back to Jersey, you know, with no money, you know, I already had coke and all that shit on the street. So, you know, I just went the fuck home. But some niggas, it was cool. Some niggas was cool with that shit. But the topic of the show, you know, that's the topic of the motherfucking whole situation. Niggas that act like they got love to this fucking day. But if I say something, then I'm a fucking troublemaker. Man, niggas don't, man, fuck everybody. I don't give a fuck about none of them niggas, but, and they don't give a fuck about me. But nah, them niggas, man, niggas be fake as hell. I don't give a fuck who listening to nothing. Niggas be faking. Niggas will say some shit. Listen to the music, some of that shit. Man, them niggas be actually talking about Pac in their music. But fans be so fucking dumb, and niggas I'm with, like, even some of my niggas, like, niggas be so fucking dumb, they be kissing ass with all these stars, and them niggas don't even fuck with Pac. Them niggas are liars. They getting their music. Niggas will hear that shit and try to act like they don't hear it. Nigga, I hear it and fuck niggas. Like, I don't fuck with niggas. I don't get in videos with niggas. Like, if it, man, please. If I ain't need a little bit of money, I wouldn't even be on songs with these motherfuckers. These niggas is clowns. Every last one of them.
Wow. Well, okay, I have another caller that have a question. Caller 9666, you're live in the sandbox. Do you have a question or comment for Fatal? Caller 9666, do you have a question or a comment for Hussein Fatal?
No.
You're live in the sandbox.
Are you single, Fatal?
No.
Great. My bubble tonight.
No, I'm not.
That's good. Well, congratulations.
Oh.
Sexy man.
Thanks.
Oh, wow. Oh, boy. Fatal. Also, I didn't see that one coming, Fatal.
Oh, no. Nah, it's all good.
Yeah, it's all good. Yeah, so like you said, you know, if anyone is just tuning in the sandbox, our topic for today was what's more fatal, love or hate, and we built our topic around our special guest, Fatal. And like you said, you know, some people, they just really be hating and doing crazy stuff. I think jealousy is a part of hate as well. What do you say about that, Fatal?
I mean, jealousy conjures up the hate. It starts with jealousy first before it gets to hate. You feel me? Once you jealous of somebody, you just jealous of them for what? You want to know. But then after your jealousy don't work, motherfuckers start telling lies, and then that don't work. You be like, fuck it, I just hate that nigga. Fuck that nigga. Can't stand him.
Right. Caller 4392, I see you're live in a sandbox. Do you have a question or a comment for Fatal? 4392?
Yeah, it's Scotty Mack. Fatal's a legend, man. He's been down forever, and I bump everything he's got, you know. Riding all week on him, that's all he does, man. Keeps it real
Lord.
Every day of the week.
Appreciate you, bro. I try,
yeah,
man. I try. I try
you
to
do,
keep
man.
It real and right. I try to keep it
you,
real and right. Because even
do,
real is a word that's being bounced around. You know, niggas say they real, that don't mean they right.
No, you keep it to the heart, man. You know, man, 1995, I heard you on a plane going to London, England, man, and it was nothing but straight raw honest, man. And since then, it's been on, you know, Outlaws University. I bumped out every day, Thug Life, Illuminati,
yeah.
Weird Out.
Yeah,
tell everybody about it. Everybody asks about where you get it. I tell them where to go, man.
I appreciate that, bro, because without that support, then we'll be somewhere stuck. Believe me, without the true, real hip-hop heads, we'll be somewhere stuck, and it's fucked up. It don't even come from the
It don't even come from the, you know, it barely comes from the United States of America. It barely comes from our own community. It comes from the people that motherfuckers is trying to shun away from hip-hop, if you know what I mean.
Oh, I know what you mean, man. I got a question for you, though. You did one of your songs, and you were talking about Pembroke. Is that down in the States? Because where I live in Canada, up in northern Canada, I live in Pembroke, man, and first time I heard that was dope.
Oh, yeah, when I said Pembroke.
Yeah,
I don't know. I think I might have ran across that shit sometime in my time, but I don't know exactly what I was talking about when I said it, but I just knew, I knew it was something called that. I think that's in that song called on the interview CD and shit.
Yeah, I live up on the 613 in a place called Pembroke, and under it it says Heart of the Valley, man. And man,
is
that's
that
what
right?
You got. And that's what you spit, man. Like you spit the truth all the time. You noble and easy, man. You hold down all the time, man. Actual, you guys all rock, man. Like
that's what's up.
Yeah, man. I just called in to say respect, man, and word up.
Y'all appreciate it,
thank
man.
You.
Yeah,
thank
man.
You,
L-L.
Caller, for being supportive.
Right, oh, you got to be supportive to the truest movement in the world, man. Nothing better than pocking the Outlaws.
Yes.
Thank you, caller. We really appreciate it. Like he said, Outlaws for life. Also, we have another caller. Caller 2393, you're live in the sandbox. 2393?
Yes.
Yo, what up?
Hi, caller.
Hi. Hi, Fatal. This is Martha. And, you know, I've been listening to the interview, and I just got to say, how do you deal with the rumors about Pac? And what do you have to say when people post videos on YouTube and say that he's been spotted with you guys? How do you respond to?
I mean, he hasn't been spotted with us. I mean, my thing is, if that motherfucker, I mean, if he my man, so if he wanted people think that he's alive, then I'm going to help him with that kind of shit. I've never seen him dead. I didn't go to no funeral. We didn't parade his body around the streets like everybody else. Like, you know, I mean, if, I don't know what the fuck is going on. I really don't, you know, I don't pay no attention to that shit. You probably do be seeing him, but his plan is working to fucking perfection. Nobody's going to believe that's him after all this time. Everybody is going to be paying attention to whatever they're paying attention to. You can say, I saw Tupac at Walmart, and everybody's going to be like, oh, yeah, it was a lookalike.
Well, what did you think of that hologram at Coachella?
Fuck that hologram. The hologram was dope, but the people that was motherfucking trying to be with rap with the nigga was corny as fuck. Like, why the fuck would you want to? Niggas is even scared of that fucking hologram. You see, they ain't want to get too close to that shit. Fuck that hologram. Because the right people ain't perform with that shit. It was unbelievable. It wasn't believable.
That shit was clownish. To this day, we supposed to be, man, let me shut the fuck up.
Love be so hate, but the fake be so fucking real. Let's just say that. But fuck that hologram. It was nice, though.
Well, thank you so much for your questions, answering those questions. And
I appreciate you.
I look forward to your work, and I want to also say that I had a chance to look at your website and your fitness blog.
Right.
And I wanna drop about 50 pounds. You have anything on there that could help me with that on your blog?
Oh yeah, well, you know, I'm not a pro at the shit yet. Every time I put something up I can always do better, but for starters, if you read that blog and probably follow that shit for like 2 to 3 weeks, you know, it'll probably work out for you and you'll see results. But you, I can always put something better, and I'm trying to put something up like every week for you guys. So
well,
just hang in there.
Well, see, part of the problem is I drink beer and I can't stop, and I smoke cigarettes and I can't stop that either. So I just need to figure some kind of way to kick the habit, because I see, you know, your blog says basically you got to be 100.
Yeah, you got to, well, nobody's going to stop nothing. You got to just chew, you know, portion control. Just try to cut it down a little bit. And as you cut it down, you'll find yourself not wanting it at all. So let's just start by just cutting it down a little bit. How about that?
Cutting down like the drinking because it's like a routine. I get up, I smoke,
yep.
I drink, and I smoke, and I drink. And
yo, if I could do it, anybody could do it, because I'm telling you, I was a lost cause in the streets. Believe me, if I can do it, you can do it. And instead of getting beer, get some water or something. It's going to be hard, but shit. I got beer right here right now, but I'm going to get my ass up and go to the gym and jog tomorrow.
Well, see, that's
right.
My thing. I like to watch TV and, you know, but, you know, you inspired me, and I'm going to really follow your advice. And I just want to say thank you so much for posting this blog.
You're welcome. You're welcome. I do it for y'all. I do it for y'all.
Yes. Thank you so much, caller. That's someone that's watching your fitness. So, I mean, I'm trying to get in shape too, Fatal. I mean, I got to get it going on so I can, you know, be ready for red carpet and everything.
Right.
But I want to ask you another question, Fatal. I'm sure you've been seeing a lot of, hearing a lot about different people playing as different legends and doing movies on people. If you had to do a movie on Pac and you would want someone to betray Pac, who would you choose?
I wouldn't do a movie on that. You can't do a movie on something. So, I mean, that shit, you can't do it. See, movies are fake. You can't do a fake-ass movie on something so real. Look at a Leah movie. Some shit, you just got to leave it the fuck alone.
Yes, yes. Don't get the going, because
yes.
Grandma Puddin' is getting the going. Grandma Puddin' to get the going and going about that movie.
In order for them to do a movie on Pac, they're going to have to wait for a whole generation to get old and die. They're going to have these new motherfuckers that don't know nothing about that shit or just know a little bit about it. That's probably why they're waiting so long. They can't come out with that shit for about another 10, 15 years. Other than that, it's going to be booty, especially after they did that shit with Aaliyah.
Yeah, that Aaliyah movie sucked.
Yeah, they had
a company called Half Ass Productions.
Right, and then with all these, you know, everybody got the same motherfucking story on Tupac. Like, if they ain't fucking with the real niggas, that it's only one time in his life that's not told. One time in his life that everybody don't know that they not getting because they don't want to fuck with the realest. They don't want to fuck with the people who had the most to do with him. And that's what's going to fuck it up. Motherfuckers want to know about what was going on after he got out of jail up until the time he died. All that other shit, reading and shit, trying to do a movie off of somebody just by reading shit. And just probably some niggas that got something to do with the production listening to this fucking interview. That's why I'm not putting my book out. All they're going to do is get that part and try to motherfucking put the movie out. I'm gonna keep
so
that one in
speaking
the
of, yeah, speaking of the book, what is the title of the book and where can they find it?
Oh, you can't find it nowhere now, but the name of it is going to be Journey with an Outlaw. It tells you about, it's basically an outlaw story. And then it's about my life, how I grew up, how I met, you know, Gaddafi, what I was doing in the hood and all that shit before I met Pac, how I got with Pac, how he died. And then it goes on after that shit.
Wow. I mean, I'm glad that you're on here and you keeping it real, and I see that you have a huge following and a lot of people, you know, you're one of their favorite outlaws. And
also, speaking of the Outlaws, I remember paying attention to Made Nigga, and I was looking at the video and stuff, and I wanted to know, like, where did that concept come from?
That was Pop. He, Made Nigga. Because the motherfucking Italians, you know, they made men, so the loyalty that the Italians have for each other, that's the loyalty we had. We didn't get loyalty by kissing each other on the fucking mouth or nothing like that. We was loyal on some Italian mob shit, but we was niggas. And you know Pop, he said, yo, we gonna be made niggas on some Italian mafia mob shit. We made men, we made niggas. And that's what it was.
Oh, that's where it comes from.
Yep.
Wow. Well, it's been such a pleasure to have you in the sandbox, and I can't wait to everything get done with your book and everything, and with your everything that you're doing, your whole movement for the Outlaws.
Can
you tell the people how to follow you, if you have anything on Twitter, social media, your website? Go ahead. I want you to go ahead and plug to all of my callers, all my listeners, all my followers for the Sandbox. Can you go ahead and plug it?
Yeah, we got at Fatal Velly on Instagram, at Fatal Velly on Twitter. What else I got? I got that motherfucking FatalVelly.com is the blog site I got going on. At OutlawUniversity.com for the shirts. At Outlaw University on Instagram. And, you know, we move.
Mm-hmm. Right. And make sure I need you to go ahead, Fatal, and give a shout-out right now and let everybody know they're tuning in live to the Sandbox with yourself and Elegant, Miss Diamond Tracks and Grandma Puddin'. And I want to say thank you so much to all my listeners, all my callers. It's been such a pleasure to have someone of your magnitude to join our show. I feel so honored and so blessed to have you to be a part of the Sandbox. And go ahead and do your thing, Fatal.
Yeah, let me give a shout-out. You tuning into the Sandbox Live radio station with Miss Elegant Diamond and Miss Grandma Puddin'. Yeah, Outlaw.
Miss Diamond Track.
Oh, my.
Yes.
Sorry about that, Miss Diamond.
Boy. Miss Diamond Track's gonna kill you. Go ahead and say it again.
Shout out Miss Diamond Track, Miss Grandma Puddin', and Miss Elegant Diamond. Did I did it right?
Oh.
Shout out Miss Elegant Diamond.
Right.
Miss Grandma Puddin' at the Sandbox Radio Station. You tuned in to the greatest.
Tuned in to the greatest. And speaking of the greatest, you know, Tupac was one of the greatest outlaws, one of the greatest groups ever. And like I said, I'm so honored, so blessed. And right now we're going to leave you all with Tupac, I Ain't Mad At You, featuring Danny Boy. I love you all. Have a blessed one. And this is Tupac, I Ain't Mad At You. I Ain't Mad At You. Fatal.
You better not
change. Shit. I guess change is good for any of us. Whatever it takes for any of y'all niggas to get up out the hood. Shit, I'm with you. I ain't mad at you. Got nothing but love for you. Do your thing, boy. Yeah. All the homies that I ain't talking to in the crowd, I'ma send this one out to y'all. Know what I mean? Cause I ain't mad at you. Heard y'all tearing up shit out there, kicking up dust, giving a motherfuck. Yeah, nigga. Cause I ain't mad at you. Now we was once two niggas of the same kind, quick to holler at a hoochie with the same line. You was just a little smaller, but you still roll. Got stressed to YA and hit the hood swole. Remember when you had a Jerry curl, didn't quite learn. On the block with your Glock, tripping off Sherm. Collect calls to the tip, saying how you changed. Oh, you a Muslim now, no more dope game. Heard you might be coming home, just got bail. Wanna go to the mob, don't wanna chase tail. It seems I lost my little homie, he's a changed man. Independent now, no sinning in the game.
entertained, then go ahead, cause I ain't mad at you. Mad at you. And cousins fighting, playing dozens, old neighborhood buzzing, knowing that we buzzing. Used to catch us on the roof or behind the stairs. I'm getting blicked and I reminisce on all the times said. Besides, moving and grinding wasn't nothing on our mind. In time, we learned to live a life of crime. We'll grind us back to a time was much too young enough. I caught a felony loving the way it could bluff. And even though we separated, you said that you wait. Don't get nobody no cookie while I be locked up safe. I kiss my mama goodbye. Wipe the tears from my lonely eye. Said I'll return, but I gotta fight the fix to rise. Don't shed a tear, cause mama, I ain't happy here. I put trial, no more smiles for a couple years. They got me going mad. I'm knocking busters on their backs in my cell, picking hell. I know one day I'll be back. As soon as I sat down, I told my girl I'll be there, so prepare to get fucked down. The homies wanna kick it, but I'm just laughing at you. Cause you's a down ass bitch, and I ain't mad at you. Went from a nobody nigga to the big man on the block. He's Mr. Local Celebrity, addicted to moving G, most hated by enemy, escaping the luxury. See, first you was our nigga, but you made it, so the choice is made. Now we gotta slay you